saw the expression on Peterson's face. He missed it way outside. It's a Red Sox team that can beat you a lot of ways. They've got 10 stolen bases so far this year, only caught twice. None of your typical American League club base at a time.
Now the backdoor slider just missed.
I think he missed there. Turn around the plate.
I think it's outside. It's a lead wire skirt strike.
This is a professional AB right here. It's a very tough lineup to negotiate. Peterson was betrayed by his defense in his last start against the Cubs. Made two errors in that fateful fourth inning because he could not survive. Wound up giving up six runs, three of them earned. Vasquez on deck. This would be the 10th pitch of the at bat to Bogarts. He reaches for that one, and McNeil is there to field it. Nicely done by Peterson. He gets Bogarts on the ground ball for the first down.
Nice hustle down the line by Bogarts there.
So Peterson's retired the first four on a strikeout of three ground balls. We've talked about it often this year that the Mets pitching staff is currently constituted as a ground ball heavy staff. In fact, that staff has generated 51% ground balls this year, which is tops in the major leagues. And up until yesterday, it looked like an incompatible mix with the Mets defense. And that certainly hurt Peterson in his last start. The Mets played wonderful defense yesterday. And they're hoping for more of that going forward. One of the questions about how the Mets would array their defense had to do with what do you do when Peterson's on the mound, particularly for plays like that. But you get a lot of right hand batters pulling the ball to third base. And with J.D. Davis struggling, would they sit him with Peterson on the mound?
You know what's interesting, Gary, is that they have changed their defense a little bit. They've got Lindor and Davis. No, they're moving out of it now here with two strikes. They were playing more to pull until the two strike count.
The answer to the question, of course, is that J.D. Davis is so hot with the bat, you're not going to sit him down no matter what his defense. 1-2 to basket.
And you know how they are today. Particularly the Mets under Alderson. Sandy was always a guy that, remember, had fixed days when, okay, 14 games.
Plays it ahead off the skate of Boyle. Sergachev settles the puck for the Lightning, and now Johnson will punch it ahead. Return pass, Tyler Johnson shooting, and a save by Kincaid, who holds on. Keith Kincaid, a stop.
Colburn, I think, was screening just a little bit up high, and see Vasilevskiy just picked that puck up, gets a piece of it, and he checks it. It's behind him. In fact, he gets enough of it that it goes to the corner.
Vasilevskiy, we told you, so strong in the season's first half, but he's allowed three or more goals 18 times in the last 26 games in which he started. Early favorite for the Vezina Trophy, likely now something that belongs to Pekarinen, as the puck is played back by Kucherov. Point for Kucherov, who gains the zone. Picks up Braden Point, streaking down the left side. Put the brakes on to avoid Vatanen. Now a chance from the far side. Batted out of midair by Nico Hischier. Shot by Point is blocked away in front. Follow-up try. Oh, Kincaid got the leg out. A fine save by it out. Now, taken away by Brad. Pass ahead for Hall. Onside, shooting, and he shot it wide.
Well, that puck was spinning.
Comes to is settled here by Hall in the opposite corner. He's throttled by Strawman. Good shift here by the Devils as Severson is hit. Still able to play it back. Nico controls off the skate. Opts to bank it in deep. Strawman.
Partners over the time we spent together here. All good offensive defensemen can move the puck.
Points on consecutive nights for Butcher. Last night, that power play goal ending a 52-game drought for Will Butcher. Devils work a pass ahead. Andy Green latches onto that and plays it in deep. Steven Stamkos winds this around. Coyotes have taken a 2-0 lead over the Florida Panthers, who at the start of play tonight are 3 points back. Shot by Brad, crashing the net. Heischer scramble for the loose puck. Comes across to Hall. He'll drop a pass back.
Kincaid comes up big, but the Devils, Heischer and Bratt were buzzing in the Tampa zone. You mentioned that. That was impressive as he battled Stamkos behind the net there, Kanji. That's what you want from Jesper Bratt, who's not the biggest guy. Here's Taylor Hall, sends it up front. That puck just... to put home that rebound. And Stamkos does a good job. He comes there and lifts the stick of Bratt right there. Good chance. And then JT Miller got a good one of his own for the Lightning.
Faceoff is in the Lightning zone. Boyle will take the draw versus Cirelli. Boyle wins it back. Mueller plays it across. And now Will Butcher shooting and a save by Vasilevsky. Kunitz will get it out of the zone. Butcher plays it ahead off the stick of Michael Grabner. McDonough going back, checks traffic over the shoulder, plays it off the stick of Ernie. Racing back is Butcher, and this is an icing call against the Lightning. Time now for Cadillac Trivia. You can tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac Trivia. Who was the last player to... by RWJ Barnabas Health, official healthcare provider of the New Jersey Devils. Second period begins with 4-on-4 play for another 26 seconds before John Moore comes out of the penalty box. This is Strawman on the puck for Tampa Bay. He's hit immediately by Grabner. Puck taken back here by Heischer. Only man with a goal so far tonight. Nico cuts back on Coburn. Shoots at a blocker save made by Vasilevsky. Loose puck swatted away by Vasilevsky and skated out of the zone. Bob Coleman gets it out of the zone. Ryan McDonough, the ex-Ranger, gives here to Killorn. 5 minutes gone by here in the second period. Alex Killorn knocked to the ice by Coleman. Devils look to get it out. Girardi with the hold. Gloves the puck down. Now on Cirelli. That enables Moore to take the loose puck. Comes back the other way. Zajac to center will lift in and head for the bench. Palmieri is hit by McDonough. Puck taken back by Killorn for the Lightning. Alex Killorn will play it ahead as Gord sends it in.
Fast pace, big hit by Blake Coleman on Killorn.
This is impressive. First game back, long road trip, playing on back-to-back nights. Devils have their legs tonight here, Kenny.
Yeah, they do. And this is the best sequence for the Tampa Bay. He's low, seals the bottom of the ice. Taylor Hall was chuckling there because you saw it rolling. He wanted to shoot before Vasilevsky got set, and it kind of spun off the toe. He didn't get much on that.
Pavel Saka on the draw. Puck comes back to Schuster. Shooting and a save by Kincaid, who holds on. Will Butcher has an assist tonight on the... Puck comes back. Spring chicken when he arrived for that rookie year.
Pretty impressive list, Scott Niedermayer. One of the best defensemen I've ever seen. And Eric Weinrich, who's still in the Devils organization. Love Eric. He's a former teammate. Played with Eric a little bit as partners over the time we spent together here. All good offensive defensemen can move the puck.
points on consecutive nights for Butcher. Last night, that power play goal ending a 52-game drought for Will Butcher. Devils work a pass ahead. Andy Green latches onto that and plays it in deep. Steven Stamkos winds this around. Coyotes have taken a 2-0 lead over the Florida Panthers, who at the start of play tonight are 3 points back. Shot by Brad, crashing the net. Heischer scramble for the loose puck. Comes across to Hall. He'll drop a pass back.
Keith Kincaid comes up.
Got by Brad, crashing the net. Heischer scramble for the loose puck. Comes across to Hall. He'll drop a pass back.
Keith Kincaid comes up big, but the Devils, Heischer and Bratt were buzzing in the Tampa zone. You mentioned that. That was impressive as he battled Stamkos behind the net there, Kanji. That's what you want from Jesper Bratt, who's not the biggest guy. Here's Taylor Hall, sends it out front. That puck just... to put home that rebound. And Stamkos does a good job. He comes there and lifts the stick of Bratt right there. Good chance. And then JT Miller got a good one of his own for the Lightning.
Faceoff is in the Lightning zone. Boyle will take the draw versus Cirelli. Boyle wins it back. Mueller plays it across. And now Will Butcher shooting and a save by Vasilevsky. Kunitz will get it out of the zone. Butcher plays it ahead off the stick of Michael Grabner. McDonough going back, checks traffic over the shoulder, plays it off the stick of Ernie. Racing back is Butcher, and this is an icing call against the Lightning. Time now for Cadillac Trivia. You can tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac Trivia. Who was the last player to... by RWJ Barnabas Health, official healthcare provider of the New Jersey Devils. Second period begins with 4-on-4 play for another 26 seconds before John Moore comes out of the penalty box. This is Strawman on the puck for Tampa Bay. He's hit immediately by Grabner. Puck taken back here by Heischer. Only man with a goal so far tonight. Nico cuts back on Coburn. Shoots at a blocker save made by Vasilevsky. Loose puck swatted away by Vasilevsky and skated out of the zone by Braden Point. He's over the line. Point shooting and a riser that missed the net. Out of the box is Moore. Devils power play begins now. Point on the puck will play this back to Girardi to kill some time. This Devils power play brought to you by RWJ Barnabas Health. Cirelli at the Devils line will send one in deep. Pete Kincaid with traffic coming. Ooh. Works it away from the oncoming Alex Killorn.
He didn't see him big, but the Devils, Heischer and Bratt were buzzing in the Tampa zone. You mentioned that. That was impressive as he battled Stamkos behind the net there, Kanji. That's what you want from Jesper Bratt, who's not the biggest guy. Here's Taylor Hall, sends it out front. That puck just... to put home that rebound, and Stamkos does a good job. He comes there and lifts the stick of Bratt right there. Good chance. And then JT Miller got a good one of his own for the Lightning.
Faceoff is in the Lightning zone. Boyle will take the draw versus Cirelli. Boyle wins it back. Mueller plays it across, and now Will Butcher shooting and a save by Vasilevsky. Kunitz will get it out of the zone. Butcher plays it ahead off the stick of Michael Grabner. McDonough going back, checks traffic over the shoulder, plays it off the stick of Ernie. Racing back is Butcher, And this is an icing call against the Lightning. Time now for Cadillac Trivia. You can tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac Trivia. Who was the last player to by RWJ Barnabas Health, official healthcare provider of the New Jersey Devils. Second period begins with 4-on-4 play for another 26 seconds before John Moore comes out of the penalty box. This is Strawman on the puck for Tampa Bay. He's hit immediately by Grabner. Puck taken back here by Hischier. Only man with a goal so far tonight. Nico cuts back on Coburn. Shoots at a blocker save made by Vasilevsky. Loose puck swatted away by Vasilevsky and skated out of the zone by Braden Point. He's over the line. Point shooting and a riser that missed the net. Out of the box is Moore. Devils power play begins now. Point on the puck will play this back to Girardi to kill some time. This Devils power play brought to you by RWJ Barnabas Health. Cirelli at the Devils line will send one in deep. Pete Kincaid with traffic coming. Ooh. Works it away from the oncoming Alex Killorn.
He didn't see him in the corner of his eye, and that was a dangerous play, but Keith Kincaid recovered real well to move the puck to his defenseman.
Severson able to pick up Hall. Maneuvers over the Tampa Bay line. Tracks the puck in the corner and winds it around. Waiting for it is Palmieri. Kyle Palmieri at the circle. His pass deflects back to Vatanen. And the Devils reset. Vatanen for Palmieri. Now the pass for Hall. Shooting! And it's blocked away in front. Zajac strong on the puck. Holds the zone. They work it back for Hall. Taylor Hall shooting. Blocked.